Jericho Majors, coming back to do another review for Doctor Who. This is Season 8, Episode 2, Into the Dalek, written by Stephen Moffat, I believe, and this is Peter Capaldi's second episode as the Doctor. Now, there are a lot of good things to say about this episode, a lot of good things to be had and to be seen and to talk about. I usually have a lot of negative things to say, but in this review, I'm going to try to say all of the good things, and then at the end, kind of just have a couple of nitpicks, just to keep that out of the way. I'm going to start making these reviews a lot more positive as I've started liking the episodes more and more. Now, first off, we are introduced to the so-called new companion, Danny Pink, who is another teacher at Colville School, along with Jenna Coleman, Clara. And so far, I'm interested in him, actually. Like, I actually am looking forward to seeing him on the TARDIS and going on adventures. But mostly, I am interested in the fact that he is a soldier, or was, and now he's a teacher. And obviously, something bad happened, and some jerk-ass kid had to say something about it, or, you know, bring it up, and, you know, made him a little teary. Just the one tear, you know, like that Indian on the side of the road with the trash. I am continually amused by the fact that the Doctor always is like a couple weeks late or a couple months late and thinks he's like right on time. You know, he kind of just sees Clara and he's like, here, coffee. And she's like, that was a couple weeks ago. And he's like, oh, all right, whatever. And then let's go on an adventure. Now, we are also introduced to a couple of side characters who I cannot remember the name of. One of them, I think something blue. At the beginning of the episode, we were introduced to her, and I really, really, really do enjoy her interaction with the Doctor and how she's like, take me back to my ship. And he's just like, you gotta ask right, man. Ask right, bitch. Say it again. Say it right. She just, you know, has to say please. And I just really, really am enjoying Peter Capaldi on screen and his candor and his kind of ability to really navigate social situations. Interesting, like, I love watching him. He's really fun to watch. But I really kind of like how he's offhandedly the Doctor now. It's just kind of like, whatever. I'm the Doctor. Just whatever. You know, he'll kind of just do the TARDIS controls. Just be like, pull the lever and just, you know, be very offhanded about it. Whereas Matt Smith was like, just kind of slapping things around. And so was David Tennant. You know, these last two Doctors were very enthusiastic about it, and Peter Capaldi is just very, this is my ship. That's how I get to places. He's not really as enthusiastic. And I really think that makes way for a lot of his inability to deal with stupidity. Basically, we get the first twist, you know, that his patient is a Dalek. A broken Dalek. Or, as they keep saying in the episode, a good Dalek, which apparently does no such thing. There is a big, huge plot hole that I had bothering me most of the episode, where, the Doctor has known Daleks for a long time, and is very aware that all they can do is hate. So I don't know why, right out of the gate, he would have just been like, oh, something's broken. It's just a broken Dalek. That doesn't mean it's a good Dalek. I think he only says the phrase once, but it's in reference to what someone else said. So mostly everyone else in this episode is saying a good Dalek. And I just, you know, I feel like he should have been like, no, it's just a broken Dalek. All Daleks are bad. He kind of, you know, enter into the Dalek via, you know, shrinking in this little capsule. And, you know, they kind of probe it into the Dalek, and immediately whenever they go in there, there's these kind of Tesselector robots that kind of scout whatever's wrong in there, or whatever harms the Dalek. That's kind of, you know, just written to be convenient, because if it just seeked out anything that wasn't the Dalek or wasn't supposed to be there, it would just be killed immediately. So obviously, one of the stupid side characters, who I remember from Game of Thrones, actually. The actor was in Game of Thrones. But anyway, he obviously does something bad, or someone, you know, hits, I think, the floor or shoots something. And these robots kind of come along and they're all floating around, and I really was taken aback and really interested whenever Peter Capaldi was just like, here, eat this, or I think he told them to do something, stand still. And they all came over here, and he was like over there, and the robots were floating around him, and he was just like, alright. And he let them do the thing, and he let them kill him, just to get rid of them. He just let someone die, basically allowed someone to die right in front of him so they could get away. And that's something that's recurring with Peter Capaldi as the Doctor, that, I mean, a lot of the Doctors have said that they don't kill people, and they don't want people to die, but people do. And I really like that he's just more efficient, and he's just like, look, if people are gonna die, I'm not gonna waste my time and waste people's time. Now, most of the episode is spent inside of the Dalek, while the rest of the ship is being attacked by Daleks. So we get this other kind of gridlock-style episode where, you know, the Daleks fighting everybody and x-raying people, exterminating people. There are a couple of comments about that are made from Peter Capaldi about the memory banks and how it will, like, delete some to stay evil. So there's like little lights on the side, and he kind of says something about it. He says something very quickly, offhandedly, about the fact that those are memories and the black ones are blocked out. So that kind of leads way into something that happens later in the episode, that the first time I saw it, I was like, that's bullshit. But anyway, he gets down there and starts talking to the Dalek. Names him Rusty. I think that, you know, that was kind of funny. And he just kind of, you know, there's not too much to say about a lot of what happens until then. I mean, Clara is still being very, you know, completely all over the spectrum, you know, just completely being on the Doctor's side and being helpful, and then at the same time being completely oblivious and dumb. There's not too much to say about that that already hasn't been said. But Peter Capaldi kind of, you know, tries to, he repairs it, you know, just by sonicking it. There's like a little broken thing, and he kind of sonics it, fixes it, obviously, and then the Dalek is just like, I'm a Dalek now, I'm gonna kill everything. Ooh, he kind of starts wheeling around and killing things while the Doctor is inside of him. And while this is happening, there's kind of this moment when one of the soldiers gets killed by the Dalek, and she gets transported to the same, like, heaven or paradise or wherever the robot in the first episode was, where this new villain, who I don't remember the name of, is just like all creepy and weird. And that's, you know, just kind of setting up this arc for this season. But anyway, the Doctor kind of like shows him a new light, and he's just like, look at all this beautiful stuff. And he kind of mind melds with him, and he's like, the Dalek is seeing his memories. And it's interesting because he's like, oh, there's so much beauty and there's so much amazing things in the universe. And he starts seeing all of the hatred that the Doctor has for the Daleks. So it kind of reverts him back to being a good Dalek, which means he's just a killer that hates Daleks. He's still a murderous, like, cyborg of a thing. It's more like just a squid in a tank, but basically a cyborg. So he didn't really fix anything, and a lot of people died, and the episode was more like a setup for something later, where maybe the Doctor will do whatever he did to that Dalek to all of the Daleks, or find a way to make Daleks good and work with them, or have a Dalek companion, or something like that. I mean, they're setting something up to where Daleks will come into play in a different light. But overall, the episode was kind of how I felt about the first one. There was a lot of stuff, obviously, that I didn't like, but everything that I did like had everything to do with Peter Capaldi. The way he dealt with situations and the way he kind of handled and carried himself was still very enjoyable to watch, and as the show is about him, it was a good episode. It was pretty decent. I feel like it was more like a setup than an actual episode, but now some of the things that I outright did not like. I don't really enjoy the fact that he is like a 2,000-3,000 plus year old alien who has seen many wars, been in many wars, potentially killed millions of things, have been a soldier, has done and seen things that no human could ever comprehend, and he won't let someone on the TARDIS only because they're a soldier. I mean, he says that she's great, he says she's like kind-hearted and interesting and intelligent or whatever, but I wish you hadn't been a soldier, he says that. And I know that that's supposed to be setting up the tension with Danny Pink later, that he'll let him on the TARDIS and like him and then find out he's a soldier and be like, oh, but that's really, really messed up. The fact that he just doesn't let someone on the TARDIS because they're a soldier. I mean, if I had a chance to go on the TARDIS and I was like right there and he was like, you're awesome, you're really smart, you're really intelligent. Yeah, but I just think that it was really strange for them to write out a companion because they were a soldier whenever the Brigadier was one of the longest running companions between two different doctors. I think three different doctors. I think the fifth doctor had a little bit to do with him. Commonly referenced. And he was a soldier. He was a decorated soldier. I think that they're trying to make that a thing with this new one, maybe. The fact that since the Time War happened, he really doesn't like soldiers. But he has put guns in the hands of his companions and fought with them in the style of an army. And Jack Harkness was basically a soldier. I mean, he wasn't really, but he was an agent. So I just didn't really enjoy that aspect of the episode. And also the whole setting up of the blue character. I just remember her last name. The whole setting of her up, I felt was wasted. I mean, like I said, they set her up, made her big part of the episode and just shut her down, and that's not a companion. I feel like they could have spent their time doing other things and just had her been an extra. But yeah, overall, I give this episode a B+. I'm gonna start doing my rating systems in like letters. But yeah, I mean, I generally enjoyed this episode, and I don't have too much else to say about it, but I am excited to see Danny Pink, and yeah. So thanks for watching, guys. If there's any other questions you have, I know I probably missed a lot of stuff. Just let me know in the comments of anything I missed, and I'll try to talk about it in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.